know, we went to see some Cuban musicians. Mm-hmm. You know, the Capitol building, funny, is under repairs. Mm-hmm. That's the same time as the American Capitol is in repair. Mm-hmm. I thought that was kind of interesting. Mm-hmm. This is the hotel where we stayed. It's called Iberostar Parque Central. And this is about the moment where Obama walked on the stage to give the speech to the Cuban people. This is where we stayed. We couldn't afford to stay at the hotel because it was $600 a night.
$600.
I said, you know what? I can't afford to stay there, so I just gonna call my brother. My brother found me this apartment 2 blocks from the hotel. And we stayed there. This is the private plane that took us there. And the day of the speech, they blocked all the roads. Mm-hmm. So there was no access for the Cuban people to get in there. This is the place where he gave the speech, which is the Gran Teatro de La Habana, named after Alicia Alonso, the prima ballerina of mm-hmm. Cuba. Mm-hmm. Most of the people that were in there were governmental people, doctors, and people of, you know, some
influence.
Yeah, mm-hmm. influence. Mm-hmm. This theater is just gorgeous. This is my first time in it. Mm-hmm. And I was like over the moon being in that theater. I mean, the details are just amazing. So I was like, I got to write a piece about this. So this is what I filmed. I took some pictures and this is from the view from the top of the hotel, mm-hmm. Iberostar Hotel. You can see the theater right across the street. It's just gorgeous, and I am glad that he got the opportunity to talk to the Cuban people mm-hmm. because he talked from the heart, okay. you know, mm-hmm. and say things in Spanish and not just plain Spanish, mm-hmm. Cuban Spanish, uh-huh. which is a little different, you mm-hmm. know, like que bola, that is very ghetto, mm-hmm. you know, very mm-hmm. street-like. Mm-hmm.
and so in a real sense, you had not only an opportunity to go with the president, mm-hmm. but to see some of the things. Well, what do you think about in terms of, I think you mentioned the fact that they painted some of the buildings before
yes.
his arrival, and they resurfaced the streets and et cetera. Mm-hmm. But overall, what do you think about Cuba in terms of what you saw at that time?
The buildings, this is one of the side streets, and I'm doing a story about the people, how calm they are, but they are very excited that the president was going to be there, and this is not being fixed at all. Mm-hmm. This is one of those streets that are like really near the main street mm-hmm. where Obama was going to drive through with the motorcade. But, you know, there is a long ways to go for the Cuban government and for the country itself to mm-hmm. being rebuilt, and it's going to take a lot of money. And
How did the people feel? I mean, how do you see the people in terms of their feelings and their emotions in terms of the president's trip here?
The moment that I saw that you could feel, I still get goosebumps. The emotion was when we were at the baseball game. Because when Obama walked through that tunnel, all you feel was the trembling mm-hmm. of the whole thing. It was full of Cuban people. And they were there waiting from 10 a.m. in the morning until he got there about almost 2 p.m. And that's when you felt the energy, and they were chanting and saying his name and moving the flag. And it was very, very exciting moment for the mm-hmm. Cuban people to see that. And there was like, when I got out, there were people hanging over mm-hmm. the top to see
Just
him
to
leaving
see
and to
uh-huh.
arrive. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And so that was quite an experience with you and
yes.
your family.
Yes.
What was your mother at that time? Were the two of you together at all times? Or what?
No. I knew that I wasn't going to be able to see her again, mm-hmm. so I just saw her the night we got there on the 19th, the mm-hmm. night before. All the press got there the night before he mm-hmm. arrived, so I got to the hotel about 8 p.m., and I got to hang out with my mom for 4 hours. Mm-hmm. That's it.
And so this was about your fifth time to Cuba since you first left Cuba as a child?
Yeah, about 5 times, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I would imagine that this was one that you will probably remember more than any trip that you've ever taken there.
Mm-hmm.
And so what you're doing now in terms of the images that we see, these are the images that you're using for your own television
yes.
show. Is that not?
Yeah, this is what I filmed. All the coverage was for the Latino community, which my show is for, you know, entertainment circle. And on my website, I created a special place, pages for the videos from Cuba. So anybody can go in there and see all my videos and
what's
my video blog.
What's the site number for that?
It's Entertainment Circle Network. Mm-hmm. It's CircleTV.com.
Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to take this second commercial break, mm-hmm. and then we'll come back with 10 minutes. And we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break. Whatever, political, social, or whatever, you know, some of the old automobiles. I mean, I would
imagine your impression
about that and the general status that you mm-hmm. saw in Cuba. I mean, you know, we've got 10 minutes for that. And
okay.
So anything that you'd like to talk about, feel free to do so, mm-hmm. okay? And then we'll be able to cut this out, and mm-hmm. then we'll have... this will be an excellent show. I think this is an excellent show, what you're doing.
Thank you
here.
So mm-hmm. much.
Well, I think it's information, you know, to say mm-hmm. that we had a chance to talk to one of the persons that went to Cuba with President mm-hmm. Obama,
yeah.
you know, and then we've got it on tape.
Yeah. Well, at least.